Hi guys, today I'm going to update the SkyQ. The software on this box is currently a Q06, and Sky have recently, last month, done an update that changes the look of the SkyQ interface. And because I've been away for a bit, obviously I haven't had this box on standby, so it hasn't automatically done the update, so I'm going to do the update manually. So, settings, system information, click on the software version, see it says Q60, so click setup. Software download. Have to wait because software is in progress. Now, I've been a bit away from the actual SkyQ videos, but after I did my SkyQ Netflix video, Sky announced that they're putting Netflix on SkyQ, which is obviously no surprise to me, but other people said that won't happen. But I said otherwise, and it's happened. Because Sky in Q06 released the update on implemented the Play Ready Content Protection Protocol that enables third-party players to work on the SkyQ. So that's obviously why that was obviously a hint that Netflix was coming to SkyQ, and obviously it's been proven true. It's not quite a date yet when it's actually going to launch, but you'll be able to subscribe to Netflix via Sky, or you can have your Netflix account that you currently got and just sign in. So the idea is that if you've got a Sky subscription, you can just update the package to have Netflix part of the service, depending on what package you're on, and then obviously you'll have Netflix and it will come up more integrated into the actual operating system, so when you turn it on, the latest shows of like Netflix Orange is the New Black or the Crown will all be on the front screen of Sky Hue when you turn on. So they're trying to go for a more integrated feel. Apparently also Sky are going to enable HDR to their boxes, so that should be another improvement over what we've currently got, because at the moment SkyQ is just 4K, not HDR, which is a bit of a disappointment during launch on the Q Silver box, but it looks like Sky is going to rectify that problem. I didn't think it was going to be able to be implemented. I thought it was a hardware constraint on the actual current box, that they might have to produce a revised version of the SkyQ, but it seems thankfully that the box has got capability enabled. So what I can actually do is, whilst this is doing the update, actually get out of this and go on to other parts of the SkyQ whilst we're waiting. So BBC iPlayer, of course, we've still got ITV, All 4, Channel 5, Sky 1, Sky Atlantic, Sky Living, Sky Arts, Sky Sports, Sky News, Fox, Alt, UK TV Play, W, Gold, Comedy Central, Universal TV, Sci-Fi, Discovery, MTV, geographic, history, alibi, TLC, challenge, E, pick, crime plus, lifetime, vice, Eurosport, Star, Sony, ZTV, Cartoon Network, Boomerang, Nickelodeon, Nicktoons, Nick Jr., Disney Jr., Disney Channel, Disney XD. So Sky's got one of the largest catch-up services on any box, which these are all available on the Sky Plus HD anyway. But Netflix apparently won't be, which is no surprise there, but Sky have recently updated this interface on Sky Plus HD again, and it's starting to look more and more like the Q-Box. I'll have to do that in another video. As for current apps, because I haven't had the update yet, so far I've just got YouTube, Vevo, and Red Bull TV. Let's go to settings, let's go to system information, let's go to software. You can see it still hasn't updated. It still says it's in progress. So it should be ready soon. When the update has taken place, we're going to see a big difference in how the interface looks. DNA. Signal's good. We'll complete the installation when it goes into standby. Well, I'll just standby and then turn it on. Okay, so has just rebooted. Seems to have gone down to 720. Please do not switch off. Well, that's a given. We play the waiting game. weird. To use this service, you need to upgrade your subscription. See how everything's just like shifted slightly? I'll change the logo again. Yeah, it seems to be a little bit more lighter, a bit brighter. So it looks like the card is may have just unpaired. Okay, so let's just go to. Right, let's turn it off and turn it on. The service needs to be opened to give you upgrade. Okay. Seems we found any fault with the box. Done that. It says go to settings. There's going to be an issue with a paired card. Broadband connection is well, it was active unless it's let me just check this. Seems updating the box has caused me some issues. Okay, seems to have fixed the issue. I don't know what happened there. So all the on-demanders stayed pretty much the same. It may have slightly altered in appearance, but it's all there. Nothing new there. Now let's go to online videos. And go to apps. Right, okay, so the same My Apps here as the world before, so other than just a slight reappearance, not really got anything new here. Spotify was supposed to be added. Oh no, there it is. So it's not in apps, it's just there. Okay, good. At least we got that now. So Spotify is the new function to the Qbox. And it says to use the service you need to upgrade your subscription. I think I've just generally got a fault here because it's constantly coming up with that, and then eventually it then works. Because I've had that with the ketchup TV. That wasn't working, now it does. Box sets. That wasn't working, now it does. Sky Cinema. Sky Store. Yeah, it's all working now. Okay, so that's pretty much it. Thanks for watching, and don't forget to subscribe.